Hello and welcome to this unusual AI coffee break. Today we'll give you a teaser about some of our own work which was accepted at ACL Toronto 2023. We will present it in July, so if you happen to be at ACL in Toronto, do not hesitate to say hi. So here we'll leave you with a bit of what we have recorded to present our paper. Hello, we are happy to present our work on MM-SHAP, a reliable way to measure relative contributions of individual modalities in multimodal models. Why is measuring multimodal contributions important? Vision and language models have better and better performance across all possible VL tasks, but can we trust that they do this for the right reasons? Fundamentally, these models are transformers that work on text and image input. They are trained, for example, with the image sentence alignment objective to say whether a pair of text and images match or mismatch. Now, there is reason to believe that not all modalities matter for these models equally, since they can suffer from unimodal collapse. This means that even if trained multimodally, a model can exploit one modality far more than the other, and indeed, we observe that on multimodal tasks, unimodal baselines can be close in accuracy to multimodal models. The reasons are often dataset biases, for example, how many questions can be confidently answered with 2 if 2 is the most frequent answer in the dataset. Or if questions about existence of an object can be typically answered with yes due to the so-called plausibility bias. Previous work has used model performance to assess a model's focus on a modality, for example, by testing whether it is sensitive to changing matching image caption pairs into mismatching ones, or by measuring whether their accuracy changes when exchanging existing images with random ones, and questions for VQA with random questions, or by deleting image regions or text tokens and measuring whether model performance changes. But accuracy-based measures are not ideal. For example, the visual importance considers the difference in model accuracy when it uses both vision and text and with missing visual information. This is problematic for wrong model predictions, since in these cases the first term is 0 and we expect the second term to be 0 too, and this results in a visual importance of 0. But the model may well have relied on the visual modality but incorrectly. So we propose a performance agnostic measure of multimodal contributions. First, we rely on Shapley values from game theory. Shapley values compute a fair payout for each player based on their contribution to a game's outcome. For example, if machine learning were a soccer game, we would first assess the base value, which is the game outcome when no player is playing. Then we gradually let them play and measure in all possible combinations of teams from our available players what the game outcomes are, and we determine how much payment they deserve. For transformers, the players are tokens, and they receive payouts from their contribution towards the model prediction. For example, the probability or activation value computed for a sample, irrespective of whether its prediction is correct or not. We take the difference between the model output with the token being active and with it inactive, and we do this for all possible combinations of tokens switched on and off. To get the contributions for a token, which can be positive or negative, we sum up and normalize over all marginal contributions. For vision and language transformers, we have image tokens and text tokens, and we can compute their contribution towards the model prediction, such as the image sentence alignment score. And luckily, none of those computations are accuracy-based. We define MM-SHAP by calculating the contribution percentage of text tokens and compare it to the contribution percentage of image tokens, which can be extended to multiple modalities. For image sentence alignment, we hypothesize that image and text contribute equally on average at corpus level because it is useful when comparing different models on the same task and data. Using MM-SHAP on sample level, we see how image and text tokens contribute towards the predicted 99% image sentence alignment score in blue, and tokens that contributed against in red. Introducing an error in the caption decreases the alignment score, and the token contributions reflect the misalignment, with the token keyboard showing negative contribution. At dataset and task level, we see that models such as CLIP are multimodally balanced, while ALBEF models are more textually focused. This trend holds over VQA as well. And on the VAS benchmark, testing models with fine-grained mismatches, we see even better that CLIP is balanced, LXMERT has a higher visual preference, while ALBEF models are more textual, showing that different VL models behave differently on the same task. Fine-tuning also affects multimodal contributions, and with MM-SHAP we can measure how much, even in cases where task accuracy is very low and accuracy-based metrics would fail. Throughout our analysis, we consistently plotted both accuracy and MM-SHAP scores because we envision MM-SHAP to complement accuracy, not replace it, since we are of course interested in how well models solve a task. But it's only by using accuracy-agnostic metrics such as MM-SHAP that we can measure how much models rely on each modality. We invite you to read our paper for more details. Thanks for sticking until the very end of this. It's great to see somebody is interested in the work I do for my PhD. You know, it's not much, but it's honest work. And if you like this, maybe you like other videos on our channel. If you like work from large companies with huge collaborations, then maybe you want to check out Velo to see how neural networks can work as optimizers for other networks, possibly replacing Adam. Or if you would rather have something by smaller collaborations, maybe check out this one, a watermark for large language models, and maybe the Paella diffusion model. In any case, we hope to see you next time.